at Cusick Park in Ennis. Now it's Aron Levine. Clare captain Tony Kelly won the toss and they're going to play from right to left. There's a little bit of a breeze and it's helping Cork, but it's not really a factor at all. Johnny Murphy of Limerick, 23 years a referee, is the man in black, the man in charge, and we are underway at Cusick Park in Ennis, and onto it straight away is Cathal Malone. There's Tony Kelly. We'll see how Cork will handle him over the course of the 70 odd minutes, but they've got to get closer to him than that, and Tony Kelly in already, and Clare leads in Ennis, and he is on it. That's great news for Clare.
It is exactly the start to see Kelly going for it there. The inside forward line of Clare now is Duggan, Rogers and McCarthy are all inside.
Now here's the Cork response. That was Luke Mead. Cathal Malone, you'll see him at the nine on his back, himself and David Fitzgerald, two colossal men around the middle of the field. Now it's Ryan Taylor. Taylor shoots. Second scoring attempt, and they put that one over as well. What a start for Clare.
Yeah, great score. The breeze into that side there is right to left. See Taylor getting on it and getting it just over the bar. The breeze just floated in lovely.
Let's not get too bogged down in permutations. You know, Clare win, they qualify for the Munster final. Cork need to win one out of their last two games to be assured a place at least in the top three. Here is Aidan McCarthy, didn't play last weekend. We weren't told what the injury was, but he's been their top scorer. Kelly was on the freeze that day. That was Peter Duggan with the hand up. Rob Downey for Cork with the clearance. Now, John Conlon is trying to get across to deal with Conor Lehan, and Lehan has dropped that one well short. Now, Patrick Corgan, you could see there was a bit of a coming together with one of the Clare defenders. The official saw nothing wrong with that. Here's Shane O'Donnell, 2022 All-Star. O'Donnell stopped by Patrick Collins. So Collins letting that move quickly. Wow, that was brilliant from Adam Hogan. In a way, he got lucky, but there was a fair bit of skill involved with that. Darragh Fitzgibbon was trying to get in behind him. A battle for the ball. David McInerney is stuck in there, but now it's Luke Mead. All very tight down there. Who's on the 13 or the 20? And it's come through to Horgan. Horgan for Cork. Trying to walk it in. Is it in the back of the net? Let's see what the umpires do here. Johnny Murphy, the referee, going in to talk to the umpires. The ball did end up in the back of the net, but how did it get there? That's the issue.
Yeah, well, the Clare defence did everything in their power to not try to foul Patrick Horgan when he's only 2 foot away from your goal line. This is a great angle on it here. I don't know how he got into the net. Maybe he got it off the hurley. If he did, he's Patrick Horgan himself is claiming he kicked it with the right foot. He did, and he's claiming he threw it into the net.
That's what the referee has said.
Yeah, it's a free
he
out.
Threw it in.
Clare backline did really, really well there, Darry. You would have expected there that they'd put enough pressure on Patrick Horgan to foul him, but they didn't. They did really, really well.
That
free out.
Like a bit of a Joe Sheridan moment from 2010. Ivor Quilligan re-established himself as number one choice in goal for Clare. That's Niall O'Leary, Kieran Joyce. Now, if Cork can get him the space, so the referee spotted something off the ball, yeah. So the free will be well up the field. There was a short pull. I don't know how the referee spotted that, because
Conor Cleary on Seamus Kennedy. Seamus was coming in from deep around the penalty area, just looking at it off the ball. Conor Cleary got caught slightly. Downey got a chance to put his head up. And Conor Cleary just panicked slightly. It'd just be a tick.
So Patrick Horgan standing over the free. I think we can write this one down already, can't we? So Patrick puts the ball between the posts. So it took them 4 minutes to get their first score. There's Pat Ryan. Under 20 successes, two of them in a row. So many youngsters brought into this Cork team. That's Brian Roach, he's one of them. Just shortened the stick, and here they come. Luke Mead running the ball. Brian Roach now again, he's full of energy. They tried to foul him and couldn't. Now Patrick Horgan, that's better from Cork, much better. Brian Roach right at the heart of that. Horgan with the point, he's got both of the Cork scores.
Class score, Brian Roach read the puck out lovely. Clare had a bunch and break, lead it up the field. Cork, once they turned it over, were able to use their legs. Great score.
Long puck out again. Tony Kelly, well, it touched off his hand. Aidan McCarthy is there. Conor Lehan back helping out. They turn it over. Brian Roach to Decky Dalton. Used to be a goalkeeper in his younger days. He's not exactly old, so that one's gone wide. He's a long-range free specialist. We saw him practicing then before the throw, and he didn't miss any. Kieran Joyce. Luke Mead ended up on the ground. That's Rob Downey, Owen's brother.
Good pressure. Line ball.
That's David Fitzgerald. Aidan McCarthy went after it. Cork continuing to grow into this. Conor Cahalan, there's good movement from Seamus Harnedy. He got away from Cleary, made space easily. He knew what was happening there. Conor Cleary was sort of confused, and Seamus Harnedy makes it 3-2 to Cork.
Yeah, it's 2v2 inside there, Dara, for most of the start of this match. Harnedy making hay. He was fouled earlier by Cleary, who couldn't tug him this time. It's dangerous for both full back lines here if the outside players like this get to put their head up.
Now here comes David Fitzgerald. This fella is a colossus in the middle of the field. Give him the ball, the result inevitable more often than not.
Yeah, he's been really good, the size and power of him. Kilkenny had a fella called Mick Fennelly, used to be doing that, yeah. Running down the middle, you'd be afraid to go to him, but he's so consistent around that middle of the field.
So that point brought an end to three in a row for Cork. Adam Hogan is the right cornerback for Clare. Really strong player. So's Dermot Ryan. He's had a fantastic year. Tony Kelly, give it to Kelly, and off he goes. Tommy O'Connell can't get near him. He's not giving up, though. Tony Kelly, point. Yeah, that's a really good score. And Kelly, you can see it in him. There's a big game in him today.
There is. You just know he's going to do you on that up along the sideline where he pretends to hit it and goes again. In fairness to Tommy O'Connell, he kept pace from as best he could. Short hurley over the bar. Never in doubt when Tony gets that opportunity. Great score.
Brian Lohan, 4 years in charge of this Clare team. Long puck out from Collins. What a catch. Decky Dalton missed one not so long ago. Dara Fitzgibbon is forced a little wide. That's John Conlon in front of him. Dara Fitzgibbon for Cork. Great score. Really, really good score.
Yeah, great win from Dalton here. You can see him. This is the key in the modern game of hurling. You still have to try to win primary possession. Gives Dara Fitzgibbon the opportunity.
So we're back in the air again. That pucker didn't quite work. Shane O'Donnell was kind of caught on his heels a bit. Tommy O'Connell will move out around the middle. There's Kieran Joyce. Not his best pass. Dermot Ryan couldn't hold on to it. Cork have it. Dara Fitzgibbon. Clare able to turn it over. I mentioned they're concerned about giving away soft frees. They gave away one already. There's Brian Roach. That was a bit too lackadaisical, really. And here come Cork again. It's Patrick Horgan. Goal chance there in. That's definitely a goal now. Conor Cahalan could not miss. Eva Quilligan could do nothing about this. They had one ruled out earlier on, but there's no doubt about this goal.
Yeah, it was a great finish. Great composure. Patrick Horgan found the right pass. Cahalan went right into Heber Quigan. There's no way he was going to make a mistake and just hung it up. It's exactly to what the Cork play has, I suppose, deserved. Dara, they've been on top in the last 4 or 5 minutes there.
Clare have lost 4 of their own puckouts. They've won just 1 out of 5. And they persist with going long. And there's Kieran Joyce just sweeping up around the back. 1-4-4, Diarmaid Ryan. John Conlon. Now that's Mark Rogers who makes a move towards that. Doesn't stick with him though. Kieran Joyce just picking up the loose ball. Peter Duggan made it as difficult for him as he could. Tommy O'Connor. Aidan McCarthy, low to Mark Rogers. Rogers shoots, and Rogers has tugged that one a little bit. First wide. And Cork on the attack again, but that's really good defending by Rory Hayes. He's an outstanding fullback. Lovely bit of skill, Tony Kelly. Nobody near him. Kelly should score. Oh, he's missed that one.
A bit of a
human after all.
Yeah, to be just tugging it there if you're a foot or two inside that left-hand post as Tony Kelly was shooting, the breeze is going to just drift it wide like what happened there.
Right down the middle, Declan Dalton was in a good position just down in front of us on the sideline. Here he is, just fakes to take on the shot that ran away from Conor Cleary. Breaks for Brian Roach. He is full of energy, can go left or right. Goes to Conor Lahan. Lahan, difficult angle. Good stop by Quilligan. Really good stop by the Clare goalkeeper. Out for a 65. Could have been a lot worse.
McCoy's a great save. Lahan did the right thing. Bounced it off the skiddy surface. Bit of rain before the match. Quilligan did really well to get down. But look how open it is inside there, Dara. It's 1v1 inside there when the ball goes in. John Conlon isn't getting back on the edge of the D like you see Kieran Joyce in previous attacks. He's leaving the Clare full back line exposed. Cork had a couple of goal chances now.
And you go back to, what was it, the 23rd of April when Tipperary were here, the day of the 5 goals, and that was what Brian Lohan wanted to eliminate. They have had, well, they've had 3 good goal scoring chances of Cork.
They have, yeah, and it's a thing that Clare, that's probably, I think, why they've been so good against Limerick. They push up all over the pitch, but the problem with that is they play a Tipperary or a Cork here, that once they break inside, it's 2v2. Now, having said that, up the other end of the pitch, yeah, Rogers and Duggan are inside as well, if you can get it deep enough into them.
Patrick Horgan. Oh. Yeah. Surprised at that. 2 wides. He's human as well. So this Clare puck out is a worry for them, not for Cork. Peter Duggan, he's won that one. Duggan wanted to give the ball off, but said, you know what, I'm going to have a go myself. Wasn't happy with the options around him, and he was right to back himself, Peter Duggan.
He is the size and strength of the man here, and then the composure. He's been a missing factor on those puck outs for Clare, because he's been inside on the edge of the square. Now he's coming out a bit, which should give him a better foothold.
And that's tucked into space. Conor Cahalan from the bars. Oh, that was good defending by Ryan Taylor. And it's worked out well for Shane O'Donnell and Clare. Nobody around him. O'Donnell went for the corner, but Mark Rogers was on his heels. Joyce. They're favouring this corner a fair bit, Cork. John Conlon with Patrick Horgan. That's going to be a free in to Cork. Horgan will take it himself. John Conlon not impressed with Johnny Murphy's call.
It was a great play from Patrick Horgan. See the way he got his right arm across there, got his body in the way of John Conlon. And see a major amount there now. But Patrick Horgan did well to manufacture that one. Years of experience to buy that free.
Yeah. Well, it's part of the game. Patrick Horgan was around in 2013, so was Seamus Harnady and Conor Lahan. Missed that 65.
Wide again.
It's another wide, so there's a bit of a mental battle going on there with Patrick Horgan.
It is, and it all fills up the Clare supporters that are around us. 65, and now that one is very unusual for him.
Eva Quilligan spotted the run of Shane O'Donnell, and that puck out's working really well now, isn't it? That's Tommy O'Connell behind him, and Shane O'Donnell, has it got the legs? No, caught by Patrick Collins, Cork goalkeeper, and out they come. Rob Downey.
There's miles of space inside here.
There really is, two against two, and the two Cork forwards darted. One went left, one went right. To the left was Seamus Harnedy. That was to his left, and that is beautiful. That's a textbook score. It's a simple game when it's done like that.
It is, and no cover in front of the Clare full back line. You can see Patrick Horgan, the bottom right, your shot is 1v1 as well inside. Here come Clare.
They sure do. Here's Cathal Malone. Hasn't been able to get on those barnstorming runs. He did a couple of them early on. Ball turned over. Luke Mead. Seamus Harnedy from St. Eta's. Brian Roach. Roach has been very good. They're just popping the ball around the place, but that allowed Clare's Rory Hayes to get in. Hayes has no stick, though. Breaks kindly for the Clare man, and here they come. Ryan Taylor, two in tow, and Taylor's pulling away from Niall O'Leary, doing it all himself. O'Leary got his own back, though. His persistence paid off. Damian Cahalan with the clearance, and Cork have numbers over here to take their time and stroll up the field. Ryan Taylor probably could have done with a little bit of support. John Conlon, anywhere will do, just get the ball away. Cathal Malone couldn't keep it in play.
John Conlon did really well there. He was caught in extra space, but Darragh Fitzgibbon did well to get something on that ball. If it slipped inside him, it was a certain goal. It's great defending.
Funny, had three converted frees in, or three frees in the game itself, never mind converting stuff.
Conor Cleary is hanging out of Seamus Harnedy again.
Yeah, and actually a couple of minutes ago the referee was in talking to both of them, and it's Conor Cleary who is in trouble, and he's got the yellow card. So the verbal warning from Johnny Murphy from a few minutes ago wasn't heeded.
You see it here on the bottom of the shot there. You can see the space, you see the Conor Cleary, you can see in front of him. Normally you'd have the spare man sitting on the edge of the D on a line ball situation, which makes the full back line a little bit more comfortable. But when there's 40 yards of grass in front of your full back line, they're going to have to give that little tug.
This is the fifth three, and it's been converted by Patrick Horgan.
And he'll be grateful for that as well, having missed a couple. See, it looks like out of pass there, gets the confidence going again.
So there was a couple of short options. That's low. David Fitzgerald couldn't hang on, but still able to claim possession for Clare. Now it's up towards Peter Duggan, having quite a battle with Damian Cahalan. Mark Rogers out. Rogers is surrounded and fouled. So you run at the Cork defenders, you run at any defender and cause them problems, they're going to foul you.
Yeah, and the common denominator is Peter Duggan. Every time the ball goes in high, it breaks. Rogers then was able to get on it and use his pace to get away. Just pull back. Sean O'Donoghue.
And Aidan McCarthy, well, he wasn't fit enough to play last week. Tony Kelly was on the frees. He scored 9 place balls. There were 8 frees and 165, 13 in total. But Aidan is back. And this is his attempt to score another point for Clare. This would be their 6th. And that's what it is, and it's his first. Their first point from a free. Darragh Fitzgibbon trying to get there. John Conlon was acrobatic and actually picked himself up off the ground quickly too. And Conlon from halfway. They've hit 3 wides. Shorter puck out. Rob Downey. David Fitzgerald is behind him, man. Well, that's what Downey was worried about. Kieran Joyce. Off he goes. Got possession, goes forward, ran into Ryan Taylor, and they've opened up some space here. Luke Mead for Cork. Malone is there. Didn't want to take on the shot. Patrick Horgan just snatched at that. There was good pressure on him, though, by Adam Hogan. And it's a big clearance, but there's nobody in a Clare jersey near that. Sean O'Donoghue enjoying being back in championship action for Cork. Damien Cahalan is another one of the 30-somethings. Seamus Harmody, the target here. 2v1, never going to work out well for Cork. Cahal Malone. Now Malone just hoists that up towards Peter Duggan. He changed the hurl, went into his right hand, and he's fouled. Well, that's really working for Clare.
It is. He's just a huge beast of a man under a high ball. It always sticks and it goes in there, and he's nearly on the break. See him going with the right hand this time. How do you mark that? Just gets a step ahead of you. It's really good, but Peter Duggan's been inside the penalty area for most of this half, and they haven't hit the ball into him. Try the odd one, the old-fashioned, get in on the edge of the square.
They didn't hang around converting the free. They're up to point number 7. So, Patrick Collins from Ballinhassig. That just broke very well for Adam Hogan. Shane O'Donnell. Seamus Harmody seems to be hurt. Shane O'Donnell, referee playing an advantage. Let's see. Shane O'Donnell doesn't need no free. He's done that himself. That's brilliant.
He has had Brian Roach out in the field there, having a chat with the ref. But Shane O'Donnell, when he gets it, he kind of ducks into the tackle here just to get away from you. The high hand there, but didn't matter to Shane O'Donnell. And the banner roar is back here in Cusick Park.
Cork 1-6, Clare 8 points. They've got the last 3 in a row. So Patrick
this
Collins
is when it gets claustrophobic, yeah. Now, Dara, he's, I was saying.
Yeah, and Patrick Collins was just trying to slow things down, halt the Clare momentum, and the referee, well, if he's done that and he's penalised Collins for wasting time, he's going to throw the ball in. He'll do it again and again, the referee.
There to Patrick Collins, he's trying to be too precise, trying to be sure the next puck out.
Well, Cork have got away with that. Damien Cahalan. Decky Dalton. Dalton, that is out of play. It's actually gone into the stand underneath us. Souvenir for somebody. Clare are, I think, going to make a change. Keane Nolan has taken... No, he's actually... He had the warm-up bib on. So we're not going to make a change. Here's David McInerney. Ryan Lohan was going to remove the flag. Tony Kelly, just to make it easier for McInerney. Tony Kelly, Cork not tight enough to him, and that is gorgeous.
I didn't want Timmy O'Connell was afraid to press on Tony Kelly. If anybody else would be trying to push him out over the sideline, but he stood back, and you can't do that. Now Patrick Collins has been blown for hitting the ball out too fast.
Side level.
Some goalies can't get a break.
Now, there you go. You just can't win. And the crowd enjoying that, but he kept his concentration and all picked up off the ground by Dara Fitzgibbon. That was a tight call. Referee was in a good position to make the decision, though.
Yeah, good run from Dara Fitzgibbon. He was just in our look, it probably was off the ground. Had a chance now for McCarthy. But you can see the momentum swing that's happened here now. Cork haven't been able to get the ball in on the 2v2 that we spoke about earlier, and this is what Clare can do to you if you can't free up a man around the middle to get it in. They will do that suffocating, and they're all over Cork now at the moment.
This is for 5 in a row, and it's for the lead again. 5 of the 6 starting forwards for Clare have scored. Aidan McCarthy has won already. It's a good distance out. The distance won't be a problem for him. The accuracy was.
He's hit it very high, but he's caught it.
So this is for Tommy O'Connell. He's been making himself available, and Shane O'Donnell has taken it off, the youngster, and he's been fouled as well. But Tommy O'Connell has been out there a lot.
Compared to Tommy O'Connell there, that one came down around his ankles. It's just a tricky one, especially the speed that they can cover the ground on. Patrick Collins just didn't hit his mark on that. Put that man in your shot under pressure. You can see him shaking the head. You only have a split second when it goes short like that. It has to go to hand.
So this isn't necessarily straightforward. I thought for a moment Tony Kelly might have a go at it, but he was over having a chat with Brian Lohan and getting some water. So Aidan McCarthy has a chance to make up for his long range miss. That one's been sent high, and it's accurate from Aidan McCarthy. So that's five in a row now for Clare. They lead.
They're under full press on Cork all over the pitch now.
And forcing Patrick Collins to hit that as hard as he could. He did a good job at it, Ryan Taylor, with the other number 13, Conor Cahalan, the Cork goal scorer. That's Luke Mead. Patrick Corgan just took his eye off it, and that allowed Rory Hayes in, but Cork have got it again. Cork have got it, and the point has been scored.
As Hernady is looking, wrapping his hands around there with Patrick Corgan. One little hand pass over the top. Patrick was happy. Great tackle from Hernady.
That was Patrick's point. Teams level again. That was their first score in 8 minutes. The teams have been level five times. Who mentioned draw? Aidan McCarthy for Clare. Tony Kelly, surprising miscontrol. You don't see that every day. Damien Cahalan. Off he goes. Three, four Clare men near him. Oh, wow, that was all very tight. Luke Mead had to be precise, and it was just fractionally off. Aidan McCarthy, he's just one to aim at. It's Mark Rogers. Rogers can't control it. Comes straight out to Rob Downey. Downey flicks it in low. Dara Fitzgibbon, he's fully fit, and Cork delighted with that, and Fitzgibbon lets that one go. Good goalkeeping by Eber Quilligan, right under the crossbar. Cahill Malone, and Malone pushed off it by Dara Fitzgibbon. It's a free to Clare, just under 10 minutes to go to half time.
It's very important, those shots you get way in the middle third like that, they have to go dead, otherwise you're caught in the counter attack, which happened there. Fitzgibbon, the man who put it short, then ends up committing the foul. And just see here now, McCarthy, the last one, he hit it very high in the air and wide left. You can be sure he'll be aiming more to the right-hand post as he looks in.
It's just so hard to judge, but he'll be well used to it. He'll know the breezes around this ground. So it's on the way from Aidan McCarthy, and he's missed it on the same side. Watching the golf last night, and Clare's drawing the ball and fading it and stuff. It's very difficult to do with one of those yellow slitters, not a small bit of white plastic. Rob Downey for Cork. Now, Adam Hogan took a risk, and he was out in front, and the risk paid off. Ryan Taylor for Clare. Gets away from Brian Roach, the ball squirts out of his hand. Shane O'Donnell making a nuisance of himself. The referee just letting that develop. There was a bit of pulling and dragging going on. Decky Dalton, that's a nice ball in, but good defending too. Look at Niall O'Leary. How did he end up there? John Conlon was across, and Clare able to deal with the danger. Who else but Tony Kelly with the clearance? Now, Mark Rogers chasing this down. Kieran Joyce sweeps across. The centre-back, there's no way through there, and he's fouled. Free to Cork.
Great play from Joyce, read it really, really well. Had his position there just inside his own 45 when he saw Tony Kelly pirouetting up on the line, made his way over. Unbelievable player for someone so young. Reads it really well.
So Decky Dalton, I mentioned, Brendan, that we were watching him practice from this kind of range. Now, OK, it was more in the centre, and actually he was poking the ball down to where the end where the Clare lads were warming up from his own half. He converted them all, but this is a little further out. That breeze is tricky, and it's going to drop short. Went over the hand of Conor Cleary, and now Adam Hogan, good cornerback play, just getting in behind his fullback, expecting the worst or the best, it depends what way you want to look at that. Here's Dermot Ryan now, and Ryan gets away from Conor Lehan. They've no Robbie O'Flynn Cork today, they miss his pace. Here's David Fitzgerald, his pace and power, the full deal. There was no foul in there, the Clare fans not happy at all. Brian Roach was in there, and Cork able to set about launching another attack. Across is Rory Hayes for Clare, and Rory flicks it out to John Conlon. Now Aidan McCarthy in a lot of space, not sure what's happened to the Cork marking around the middle third. Aidan McCarthy, and he's missed another one. That wind has to be more difficult than
just overcompensating.
We're looking at, yeah.
Knew from his freeze that they were going wide in the left. He just pushed it too far to the right-hand post there. But Clare worked the ball really well out to John Conlon to find McCarthy.
Niall O'Leary. Was there some holding in there? Rory Hayes again on the shoulder, again getting out in front. Hogan's been doing that as well, and it's paying off for the Clare fullbacks. Here's Dermot Ryan. Ryan gave that absolutely everything. Duggan is the target. It came off Cahalan, and Tony Kelly scores! Damien Cahalan inadvertently put the ball into the path of Tony Kelly, but when Duggan is in there, there is pandemonium in the air for Cork, and Clare have their goal.
I think Duggan got the hurley on this one. He did, sure enough. Get the ball logging on top of Duggan, run off him and pick up the pieces. Tony Kelly knows that only too well. When the ball was in the air, he's trying to get under it. Great score, and again, that long ball in on top of Duggan. Cork now have somebody going down.
Yeah, they could do it. The momentum been broken here. Clare 1-10, Cork 1-7.
Johnny Murphy's having none of it, play on.
And we are playing on. That was Conor Lehan, Brian Roach. This will be the first score after the goal, and that is a good response. It speaks of mental toughness, of resilience, and Brian Roach has all of those things with 5 minutes to go to half time.
Yes, great response. One thing Pat Ryan, I suppose, has done with this Cork team, you saw it below, and Páirc Uí Chaoimh and Tipperary were all over him. They just kept their heads and kept plugging away, and expect the same here in Cusick Park.
That's for Shane O'Donnell. It's missed him. In around the back was Luke Mead. Brian Roach. Really like this fella, the way he plays. Battle for possession. Patrick Horgan still has the pace, doesn't he? Conor Cleary. John Conlon. Now it's 2v1 over there in favour of Cork. Shane O'Donnell was outnumbered. Tommy O'Connell is there with him. And the two wing-backs able to figure it out. Rob Downey. Tommy O'Connell from Middleton. Now that's played into space, oh dear.
Yeah, he's looking for Fitzgibbon, just overhit it.
John Conlon for Clare, a giant in that centre-half back line. Aidan McCarthy. McCarthy letting it go again, it's for Peter Duggan. And Damien Cahalan, they continue their battle. Here's Tony Kelly, and there's a point, and he punches the air in delight. They've owned the second quarter of the first half. Tony Kelly, 1-4 now.
Yeah, he's gone inside, partnering up with Duggan. Clare have caught the fact that any high ball coming in, Duggan's going to win it. And Ferguson, they're giving it into him, and Tony Kelly has profited twice and picking up the scraps.
Cork have only 2 points since the 16th minute of the first half, and Clare have gone to town in Ennis. Aidan McCarthy. And here we go with Cathal Malone. Acres of space. He could have gone even closer in, and he should have gone even closer in. That's a bad miss. Maybe he just thought, how have I got so much time here? And lost concentration.
Yeah, this be talking there, sometimes you can have too much time. I need to go over.
Clare 1-6-2 since the 16th minute. That's going to be Clare ball.
Just good tackle with McInerney. You saw him under here with Dalton earlier on as well, the way he stood him up, that strength. Nudge, get the Cork player out over the line.
Oh, that's McInerney, and it's given straight to Decky Dalton. This is his range. That's where he loves it. He's dropped that one short. Seen it a few times. The wind, well, it should be helping Cork or assisting them. That was important for Cork. Touch of a stick there, Niall O'Leary. Damien Cahalan couldn't collect it first time, and that's all Duggan needed, just to put pressure on him, but they've stayed calm. Sean O'Donoghue, the Cork captain. Rob Downey. Downey lets it fly. There was a push there by Conor Cleary. Seamus Harnedy, and Cleary is injured. Harnedy, open road in front. Lays it off to Cahalan, and Cahalan couldn't bring it under control. They may still make something out of this, but they'll be livid if they don't get a score out of it. He'd have the Clare defence in tow, and Clare have got away with it. Conor Cleary is badly hurt, and I'm not sure if he's going to be able to continue. Is it shoulder, collarbone? But he just stopped.
Shoulder, bicep, I think, for him there. You can see just on the outside of his shoulder.
Oh, he's in a lot of pain. An awful lot of discomfort.
Just hope he's okay.
Shane Amore is already warming up.
He's had a great battle inside with Seamus Harney there.
Oh dear.
How, I'd say his arm must have got caught under Seamus and flexed up. His collarbone looks like he's in a bit of bother there, unfortunately. Not something we want to see, a man that big, grimacing, that kind of pain.
No. Oh, look, he's such an important player for Clare in that full-back line. And he was having a massive battle in there. And look, if he says he's hurt, he is really hurt. And you can see the pain on his face. And look, that's we just hope it's not as serious as we think. But he's got no mobility in his shoulder at all.
I think credit as well to Johnny Murphy there. He let the play go when Cork had the opportunity of a goal, and then when it recycled back out, there was the opportunity to look after Conor Cleary.
Shane Amore was prepared instantly.
Adds a little dynamic now as well to the game. Shane Amore wouldn't be as big, obviously, as Conor Cleary. Seamus Harney's in the edge of the square, winning a lot of high ball. They're going to trust that Adam Hogan and Rory Hayes inside can look after Patrick Horgan and Seamus Harney.
Yeah. So one added minute at the end of this first half. Quilligan looks for Duggan again. Tommy O'Connell couldn't bring it under control. Luke Mead can for Cork. And just made a little signal up the field, and that's trying to get over the head of Dermot Ryan. Didn't catch it. Luke Mead wanted players to move out from that full forward line, that inside line, and they didn't do it. David Fitzgerald hasn't seen as much ball as Clare would like. Cahill Malone from 6 Mile Bridge. Mark Rogers was available. He's gone back to Dermot Ryan, though. Oh, here they go, and there's Shane Amore, the new man in. And he's making a little bit of a statement to Brian Logan. I wanted to be in from the start.
I know, I'll tell you, it's inspirational there to have him coming out around the middle third. You can see no one marking him, no one picking him up. Great score.
Tony Kelly gets away from 3 Cork players. Oh, he's not happy with what followed that. 112-8. 112-1-8, excuse me, for Clare. Patrick Collins. And Clare have their extra defender back in there. There was a push in the back, spotted by the referee. A clear signal from Johnny Murphy.
And Seamus Harney ran into the back of everyone, really. John Conley, you see the hurley up. Back of John's head, definite free out. We're off quickly again by Clare.
Yeah, no hanging around. Dermot Ryan. Oh, Ryan's having a go, and Duggan just making sure, and that's gone over from Dermot Ryan. He scored 2 against Waterford last week. He loves that right half-back position. And Dermot Ryan, they end the half on a real high. They've taken over in the second quarter, outscoring Cork, who the scores for them have dried up. Only 2 points for them in the second quarter of the first half. It's Clare who are doing what they need to do. They lead Cork by 113-18 in Ennis.
Part of the first half in Ennis, but it is that way now. Clare leading Cork 113-18 in this absolutely crucial game in the Munster Hurling Championship. Tony Kelly responsible for 1-4 of their 113 total, but also responsible, if you look at the turnovers, in the second quarter, Cork conceded 1-4 as a result of having the ball turned over. So there is so much you can read into this. Donalogue, 18 minutes in, Anthony turned around and he said, Cork are so on top here, but they're only 3 points in it.
That was it. Like, Cork could have been a lot more up at that stage. It was a very tense opening. Cork scored a goal, but you could say they could have had, like, Patrick Horgan, maybe debatable, was he fouled or whatever, but he'll be even disappointed himself when he looks back in that he actually didn't strike it earlier, so he could have gotten that goal. Even when Cleary went off that time, when he got hurt, there was more opportunities there. So even though Cork and Clare actually looked in bother, it looked as if the Cork inside line had loads of space to be operating from, they would have been disappointed in terms of the conversion rate, absolutely.
Yeah, because as you say, that goal looked like it was coming, and there could have even been more.
That's it. Like, I know George spoke about the Clare defence, but there's a feeling that if you can get, or the Cork defence, but there's a feeling if you can get at the Clare defence, that there's opportunities to run at them. You see, they crowded out. Well, John Conlon looks in control. He probably looks up and doesn't see anything on. But Brian Roach, who was outstanding at the start of the game, made a great interception. And Patrick Horgan, Conor Cahalan's run here was excellent. His first couple of steps away gave him enough space then. It's a tough position for Eva Cooligan. I bet you there's people saying, should he come or should he stay? He's hoping to give himself a bit of distance. But it was Cahalan's run from the blind side that made the difference here. And that was Cork were in a good position at that stage.
But he did what you'd want your Conor forward to do there. He took it in to the no-save zone. Yeah. You know, if he shot when he got that ball, Cooligan had a great chance. He took it in there to... There's no chance of saving it.
Yeah.
There's also very little chance when you have somebody like Tony Kelly who is just performing the way he is yet again. How many times can he do this?
Yeah. It's almost taken for granted at this stage. But, yeah, 1-4 in the first half, straight away from, like, the throw-in. Won a difficult ball, really, and over the back straight away. Like, I don't think there's anybody man-marking him. He seems to be drifting in and out... between the full forward line, half forward line, kind of wing. I think Cork need to probably put somebody on him, maybe Niall O'Leary. I think he's picking him up when he goes inside, but like, they're giving him too much space. You can't give a guy like Tony Kelly that much space and not be punished. Here, like, just simple thing, breaking ball over the bar. Clare seem to be going a little bit more direct with some of their deliveries late on in the first half into Duggan. And 1-1 has come off just Duggan breaking it down. Now, Duggan does unbelievable here, breakdown. But it's Tony, he didn't take it in his hand. That's the crucial thing there. He flicked it ahead of himself. Like, if he took this in his hand, like, Joyce there was waiting for him just to get it into his hand. He flicked it up high and flicked it in. Like, that looks simple, but that is, like, unbelievable.
Knew exactly what he was
speed
doing.
Speed of thought. Yeah. But that's the speed of thought there. Yeah. Like, another guy would have... flicked it up or pulled on it or something. He had it in that split second, flick it up, flick. Unbelievable.
Do you know what else was really interesting there? You in particular, Joe, were fascinated with this battle between Patrick Horgan and Rory Hayes. Horgan was so on top for the early stages of that. But we noticed in the lead up to the Tony Kelly goal there, it came from Hayes getting out in front. And what Donal Oge said was, that battle is nearly mirroring the match.
Yeah, and there was a bit of... I suppose there was no ball involved much there. The two of them were tangling. There was nothing blown. Normally we see the forward getting the benefit of doubt here. Big goal chance here. Hoggy does superbly. As Don Logue said, you can probably normally expect him to have that ball gone away from himself faster. He winds up, I think, throwing it in for a finish. Ironically, he put out his leg as if he kicked it in.
No chance of a foul, is there?
Well, maybe Conor Cleary coming across, they might argue.
Not if you're from Clare, there was no foul.
No. And look, Hoggy seemed to be on top on the battle. And he missed a couple of frees. Did that affect him? Rory Hayes needed to do something different. And I think, in fairness to him, he has decided, I'm going, you've no chance playing Patrick Horgan from behind. And he has done really well, you know, since then. They dispossessed him here, have chance of a goal on there if Harnady got it. But in fairness to Hayes, he has stepped out. This is what he's good at. This is what he can do. This is why he's there, John. So, for me, we need to keep on... Conor Cleary's gone off now. That's a big change. The only thing I'd say, maybe from a positive Clare point of view, he was on a yellow for off-the-ball holding. So, I think, from what we can gather, David McInerney has gone back in full-back. Would have played a lot of full-back there. So, that, look, it might not work out that bad, but we need the Conors to keep attacking.
Yeah, so Clare, 5 points in front at the break. Remember, this is a massive game. It is Clare's last game of the Munster Hurling Championship. Cork have a trip to Limerick next week. We have the second half from Ennis coming up next. Nearly 19,000 down in Ennis, and right here in Thurles, it is thronged as well. Limerick fans probably pleased that it is Clare who are leading Cork, because remember, a Cork win ramps the pressure right up on the All-Ireland champions for their game this afternoon, which of course is against Tipperary here in Thurles, throwing in at 4 o'clock. And of course, all these rumours, as always, accompanies when you are the All-Ireland champions and the leading lights. They've been doing the rounds, but... It looks pretty certain for John Kiely and his team that those rumours about a certain former hurler of the year look to be rather on the fictitious side, as we all imagined they probably were. So that's coming up at 4 o'clock. We're awaiting the return of Clare and Cork down in Ennis. Donal Oge, from a Cork point of view, are we likely to see Shane Kingston coming in very soon? Do they have to change things up a little bit?
Definitely. Like, we talk about the Championship quarter now. The way Clare dominated quarter two, Cork need to go and dominate quarter three. They'll need to start offloading the bench. Some of the Cork forwards aren't firing. You spoke about David McInerney, Anthony. one of the reasons why McInerney was moved out in the half-back line, he's really athletic, he's good going forward, but sometimes it's questionable his housekeeping in around that full back line. Cork need to go after that and go for the kill in there if they're to come out with a victory.
They did find all the space in the early stages of that first half in the Clare defence, and Brian Roach and Darragh Fitzgibbon had a big say then. How did they get them back into the game again?
I think it's just down to work rate. I think they need to maybe shorten up their game a little bit, because Clare, after sitting back, and they are attacking from their full back line. So if they can find spaces around Fitzgibbon there, I think he's pulling off John Conlon. So if he's in pocket of space, they need to play the ball a little bit shorter. Rob Downey and these guys are going long, Tommy O'Connell going long every chance they get. If they shorten it up and go through their midfield and half forward line, I think it'll suit Cork a little bit better. I think they just need to switch up something and work a bit harder. I think like Clare are still coming out easy enough at times from the back when they're attacking the ball, and then they're launching a long ball into their full forward line.
We speak a lot about Tony, and we have to. 1-5, unbelievable. Credit Shane O'Donnell, took a ball there, joined in the middle of the field. Peter Duggan, maybe not in the greatest form, has really stepped up, and Diarmaid Ryan.
OK, here we go. Remember, this game, absolutely crucial. Let's head back now to Brendan and Dara.
It sure is. Lovely touch with the rest of the Clare panel who are not involved in the 26, forming a guard of honour for the teams coming back out. No changes to either side for the start of the second half. Clare 1-13, Cork 1-8. And a big 35 and more minutes of Championship hurling. Clare's last game in the group. Tommy O'Connell has got it for Cork, but he doesn't have it anymore. Tony Kelly just almost pick-pocketed him. And then that breaks down, and Tommy O'Connell is still going, barnstorming up the field. Brian Roach was involved there too, but they've turned it over. Tony Kelly for Clare. One forward holding on to one back. Here's Shane O'Donnell. Joyce is behind him. O'Donnell been dragged back. Shane O'Donnell lost control of the ball. It's a penalty. It is a penalty. Shane O'Donnell into the full forward line. And how many times have we seen this over the years? He's impossible to mark.
He is, even for Kieran Joyce, who's one of the best defenders out there. O'Donnell got his hand to the ball, spun him around inside. The interest to see now, is it a yellow or a black? He wasn't pulled to the ground, strictly speaking. So we'll see. It's yellow card. Yeah. He stays on the pitch, but the more important thing, I suppose, for Clare is that they have a penalty now. It's unbelievable skill from Shane O'Donnell. The last thing you want to do is have a ball bounce in front of him, be one-on-one, 20 yards from your own goals now, Darragh. That's one thing for sure.
He was just kind of wriggling away from Kieran Joyce like an eel. So Tony Kelly, TK, will take this penalty for Clare. He got 1-4 in the first half.
To be fair as well, just before we take it, it was good work from Joyce, because he didn't pull him down. He realised that, look, if yes, I can hold him up, I know it'll be a penalty, but at least I don't. And he's still on the pitch after it happens. So it's great awareness from Joyce, but either way, that man in your shot has the opportunity now to stretch it at 3 more points.
He's been made to wait an awful long time. Cork are going to make a change now. Jerm Mellerick is going to come into the full back line, but Tony Kelly has had a long time to think about this. Patrick Collins in goal for Cork. So, Tony Kelly against Patrick Collins, big moment in this Munster Championship match, and he scored. That's a wonderful penalty.
Gave him the eyes, lovely. Put him the wrong way. Just opened the face of the hurley into the bottom left-hand corner. Timmy O'Connell is the man who's gone off. Jerm Mellerick is in. Might actually help Cork in the long run. I think Jerm Mellerick could be more seasoned campaigner now, considering Cork is so far behind and up against it.
Huge score at the start of the second half for the home team. This is the 60th championship meeting. Clare have only ever beaten Cork 14 times. It's a temporary sub with Jerm Mellerick on for Tommy O'Connell, and Cork have responded with a point from Darragh Fitzgibbon.
Something that Joe spoke about there at half-time, with just working the ball to get it to the spare man. They're turned over on the puck out now.
They are turned over, but Shane Amory is there but can't hang on to it. Conor Lehan for Cork. They need another score here. They'd love a goal just to drag them right back into contention. Darragh Fitzgibbon is across. There was a push there. It's a free out. A push on Adam Hogan.
Big turning point there. Lehan got it. He was in, Darragh. He was in, and just fumbled the ball as the tackler was coming in on him. Should have got that, taken five or six steps, headed for the black spot, but he didn't. He pondered a little bit. Scrum, the defence got back, turnover. Big relief and free now for Ivor Culligan.
And he can drop this right in around Patrick Collins, the Cork goalkeeper, just in front of him. Ivor Culligan from Fecal. Well, he didn't catch that at all. Tony Kelly does. Oh, he's got to bring that under control, but he had to get rid of it. Rob Downey was on hand for Cork. And that is just tucked up into space. And Adam Hogan does his stuff. So does Dermot Ryan. Rory Hayes. They've lost Conor Cleary to a serious injury. There's Duggan. The left hand went up again. It's a big battle continuing with Damien Cahalan, and there's a free out now for Cork. And right down in front of us we can see Pat Ryan and his management team, and they are deep in conversation. Well, they were actually a second or two ago. They have issues, let's say. Collins goes to the other side, but Rory Hayes perfectly read where that was going. Just couldn't bring it under control. It just sort of skidded up off the turf. Tommy O'Connell is going to come back in for Cork. Jer Mellerick will come back off.
This one just a blood sub.
Yeah.
By the way, Jer Mellerick has latched himself onto Tony Kelly out there, and he's out there, and he's the ideal guy to track Tony Kelly around the pitch. The best man marker, I would say, that Cork have.
Conor Cahalan lets it go. And now it's Dara Fitzgibbon. Oh, they've got somebody in around the back. They have Conor Cahalan in around the back.
Tony Kelly.
Oh, Dara Fitzgibbon just let that one go. The option was to play it to his right. Tommy O'Connell back on.
He was trying to play it to his right from what I could see, but it was Tony Kelly who got back and got the hook on him. And he couldn't play the ball inside to the attacker running through. Again, the unseen stuff, I suppose, that Tony Kelly gives you.
I think he's after a bit of crystal again. Aidan McCarthy lost the stick. Kieran Joyce is there with him. Peter Duggan. Deeper now. Mark Rogers is actually the furthest forward from a Clare point of view. So John Conlon is coming across. Adam Hogan, I don't know where he left the stick, but he hasn't got it. Seamus Hardity for Cork. And that's a free in against John Conlon. Adam Hogan pleading his case. His Pearl is about 30 metres behind him.
I see him there. He doesn't wrap the hands in. You can see him there. It was good tackle from Adam Hogan. And maybe that hand on the right shoulder of Seamus Hardy might have been the one. But in fairness to Clare, their discipline, the tackle has been extremely good. They haven't been caught high at any stage. Standing up those Cork forwards as best they can. It's a big free now.
Sure is. For Patrick Horgan. Got it. So they roll on to 110. And now we're going to see Shane Kingston. Cork want to make the change. Referee Johnny Murphy wants play to continue. David Fitzgerald made his run out but couldn't bring it under control. That's a bit sloppy. And that's Conor Lehan. Can he punish them? He's dropped it short and it's a... Oh! How did that stay out? That was Seamus Harnedy. I was convinced that was going to nestle in the bottom corner.
Got too much on it, I think, if anything. It would have been interesting to see if he was going to blow for square ball. This is the long ball in. Jamie, in fairness, team follows it in.
Look at this.
Got too much on it.
Oh dear.
It's Conor Lehan is the man who's called the short.
There's Shane Kingston. Clare getting ready to bring Ian Galvin in. He started last week against Waterford. Tony Kelly ruling the skies. Ryan Taylor, and the shot from Ryan Taylor is good.
I know we say it all the time, Dara, but when Tony Kelly can do it all, look at this. Spins around. tell you, if I'm Cork, I'm getting Jerry Mellowick back out there now, to be honest with you. Timmy O'Connell is not going to be able for Tony Kelly. It takes a certain level of experience, although many have tried and failed, but
sure,
a newcomer, it's tricky on him, it's hard on him.
So that was read by Sean. I don't know who the Cork captain, well, there's still loads of time left. They could do with a healthy dose of inspiration. Here's Mark Rogers from Scariff. Two Cork men behind it. Rogers is all very tight there, and he was a bit isolated. Sean O'Donoghue to Luke Mead. Kingston has gone into the full forward line. Cork getting ready now to bring Shane Barrett into the action. Here's Dara Fitzgibbon. Fitzgibbon has Taylor behind him, lets it off to Kingston. He's only on the field about 60 seconds. Kingston, how many steps there?
Penalty.
Penalty is what has been given. It's a Cork penalty.
Been crying out inside there for Cork to have someone with the pace of Kingston. You can see him coming on there. He's been pulled back. The left arm has been pulled by Shane Amore. Good spot, obviously, by Johnny Murphy. See it here.
Yeah, that's why he was taking so many steps, because clearly he was being dragged back, and Johnny Murphy was on hand to make the call. And while the Tony Kelly penalty was huge, this is massive for Cork. So Conor Cahalan is the player going off. So Shane Barrett wears number 25. And Jer Mellerick is going to come back in too. And as Brendan was saying, I think he's going to position himself right beside Tony Kelly. It's Patrick Horgan from Glen Rovers. 11th minute of the second half. They're behind. They're well behind. Horgan against Eber Quilligan. Horgan, oh, he hit it straight at the keeper, but there's another chance, and now it's buried by Decky Dalton. He was quickest to react, expecting the best, expecting this to happen. And Cork are back.
Yeah, Eber Quilligan should have done better with that. The ball only didn't come in that quick to him. He should break it out to the side, broke it out. Dalton, to his credit, was the next man on. You can see it here. It was a good finish. Simple enough in a lot of ways for him. Quilligan should have put it out to the side. Breathed life into the Cork charge.
Yeah, we've a game now. The lead is down to four. This is Peter Duggan. Ryan Taylor, Aidan McCarthy with him, and also Dermot Ryan. And it's Ryan who has it now. McCarthy free. Ryan didn't even have a look at the post, and perhaps he should have had a more meaningful look. David Fitzgerald in at full forward, tried to keep it in play.
This is where the depth of your panel comes in now, Dara. The subs are starting to roll in.
Ian Galvin for Brian Lohan's men, and Tommy O'Connell is going off for good, well, till the end of the game, and Jerry Mellerick's in. So Clare still lead. They won't feel that way, though. The next score in this will make it very interesting. Patrick Collins took out, missed everybody. Shane Amorley going with the football skills under pressure from Seamus Harnedy. And Decky Dalton is going across to take the line ball for Cork.
I'm surprised we got this one over the bar either, in fairness to Decky Dalton.
Just spinning the hurl in his hands twice. That's kind of his thing, his little routine. Didn't work, though.
All right, at least they went dead. They can reset now for the puck out. Great response from Cork now, just the 4 points in it.
Shorter puck out, Shane Amore. There's a lot of pulling and dragging, and Damian Cahalan feels that's a big moment for his team, and just trying to inspire those ahead of him.
It's a great tussle with himself and Duggan off the ball in a foot race like that. Duggan really wants the ball coming down top of his head so he can use his strength under the high ball.
Now, we didn't see Decky Dalton convert from this range when he was practicing the long range freeze. This has gone in around the house, and let's see. Just two Cork forwards in there. Shane Kingston went after it. Patrick Horgan is there too. And here is Cathal Malone. And Malone was half hooked by Horgan. It did enough, and that's a free into Cork. It's a free into Cork as Decky Dalton, the player who took the free in the first place, followed it up the field and was then fouled, and Horgan will size up the free.
Yeah, McInerney was caught for wheels on the way back here. Dalton just that little bit too fast. He had a couple of yards of ground to make up on McInerney. Whether it's a comeback from the knock he took against Waterford or not, but he was very sluggish going to that. Gives the opportunity now to Patrick Horgan.
And he's converted. So that was the next score after the goal. Three between them. Cork playing catch up and doing a pretty good job of it. Eva Quilligan with the restart. Shane O'Donnell got a stick to that and just tapped it down to himself. That is beautiful. Half the Cork defence trying to get to him. They didn't foul him. Referee in a good position to make the call. Aidan McCarthy goes round the back. Very tricky angle for Aidan McCarthy. Yep. This will be the score of the day. Wow, that's a stunner from Aidan McCarthy.
Just amazing skill from Shane O'Donnell, the way he brought that ball down, and McCarthy just spins it over the bar from the sideline. That's exactly what Clare would have needed.
Clare's first score in 7 minutes. Brian Roach just pulled on that with Cathal Malone. Cork ball. Brian Roach didn't get the distance on it. Hard to get it above Peter Duggan. He's so tall and broad. And then it's a battle on the ground. Cathal Malone somehow brought order to that little bit of mini chaos. John Conlon. Conlon sizes up the options and lets it fly up towards Tony Kelly. Niall O'Leary did well for Cork, just spinning.
Some space in both full back lines now if it goes in long.
Rob Downey. They go short, go precise. Shane Barrett. David Fitzgerald there with him, just dragged out of him. And now Brian Roach gets the shot away for Cork, and Roach has scored.
The score well worked.
They're back to within three. Next score now becomes even more important. Quilligan. We're heading into the final quarter. Well, they're all championship quarters. There's Ger Millerick with Shane O'Donnell. Somehow Damian Cahalan comes out with the ball. That's brilliant from the Cork fullback. Luke Mead touches the ball down to himself, and you can see how fired up Cork are.
Yeah, suddenly every time a Cork ball carrier comes down with the ball, there's a guy coming off his shoulder, whether it's Fitzgibbon down the middle, Roach we saw earlier, or Luke Mead in this case.
This is their 17th game since the year 2000. Cork have won 12 to Clare's 3. There's Shane Kingston. Adam Hogan he has for company. And it's Decky Dalton. Will he nail one of these? The wind is tricky. We saw that all the way through the game. And they're up to 6 now in terms of wides. Aaron Shanahan will be next in for Clare. David Fitzgerald made the run, but he's the decoy. The ball goes over his head and right down where Clare had a 3v2. That came off the boot of Luke Mead. Kieran Joyce shortens the stick. Rob Downey. Oh, pressure put on him by Shane O'Donnell. He's been everywhere and at everything, Shane O'Donnell. David Fitzgerald, they can't pick the ball up. Shane O'Donnell can. Now, again, he tries to wriggle clear and got rid of the ball. Peter Duggan sends it back to Dermot Ryan. We are right behind that, and that is absolutely stunning. It never moved. You can forget about the wind when you've Dermot Ryan about.
Yeah, and Zayden McCarthy just coming out. Get a foothold hold around the middle third. They expect Peter Duggan now to come out in the half-forward line to Shanahan inside. Duggan's been slightly wasted in there. Ball hasn't been going in, so he's going to play now right half-forward. Shanahan on the left half-forward side. Galvin at the moment now, and Fitzgerald inside the full forward line.
Yeah, Ian Galvin got 1-1 against Waterford. Sean O'Donoghue. Back to two scores between them. Jerm Melrick. Damien Cahalan. Yeah, off he goes, gets away from Aaron Shanahan. He's got loads of pace. What about the point scoring prowess? Yeah, there's plenty of that. There certainly is from Damien Cahalan. They're hanging in there. Another goal in this for either of them would be massive. Kieran Joyce. He's got that glove on.
It's unusual that Clare have David Fitzgerald inside playing full forward. He saw Cahalan ponying up the pitch there at that stage. Lohan has given him direction now to come back out the pitch, I think. It's not the ideal to have a guy of his skill set inside full forward.
Decky Dalton. Wow, that was some hand pass. He lost the stick. Dermot Ryan is there. It's gone against him. That was a brilliant pickup. How on earth did Shane Barrett do that? They could be in here. Patrick Horgan thought about a goal for a moment. They will take the point, and that's exactly what they've got. And now the gap is trimmed down to two.
Yeah, good use of the ball. Once he got inside here, saw Horgan inside. He had that little dummy to cut back onto his right.
The pressure builds. The anticipation grows. Shane O'Donnell. Nobody in around the back. He had to do that himself, and he snatched at it. He had a little more time to steady down. Surprised to see him miss from there.
There's a Pat Ryan below us there straight away. It was a foot or two in on the pitch there, G'ing up his troops.
They go short. Sean O'Donoghue. Oh, that's always the risk. Damien Cahalan just flicks it out to Shane Barrett from Blarney. Barrett lets it go. They've three Cork attackers down the other end. There were three defenders. John Conlon with the interception. And now he can take his time. That's going to put pressure on Dermot Ryan. What a catch, though. Look at the two Cork players around him, sticking with them and fouling him too. And that takes the pressure off.
It looked like the famous hospital pass when John Conlon floated that out there with two Cork attackers coming on him. But it was a great catch. Great catch. And now Tony Kelly. Coming back inside his own 65. How many times have we seen him do this? Point it to the left-hand post and leave it drift in.
Since the match restarted, Cork have outscored Clare 1-6 to 1-3. This is a big moment for Tony Kelly. Inside his own 65. That's not going to work, though.
I'm sorry.
That is not going to work. They're up to 10 on the wides count. Tim O'Mahony from Newtown Shandrum is about to be brought in. They've been using him as a big impact sub and nearly always makes an impact for Cork. John Conlon with the clearance over the head of Shane O'Donnell. Kieran Joyce, that's what he's there to do. Just hold that defensive structure together. Jerm Melrick for Cork. John Conlon got down low. That's a great take by Conlon with Dara Fitzgibbon beside him. Cathal Malone. 2018, the last time Clare won three championship matches in a row. Dermot Ryan. And Ryan lets that go. And Ryan has scored. That's huge.
Quality. Absolute quality score from John Conlon, winning the ball in front of Fitzgibbon. Sort of working it around. With Galvin winning it here like this. Getting the composure for Ryan coming off his shoulder. Great score.
That's two in a row for him. There's so many talented forwards, but it's the wing-back who's got the last 2 points for Clare. Patrick Collins. Over Aaron Shanahan's head. Shane Kingston can't get a decent ball at the moment. Cathal Malone, by far the more dominant of that big midfield pairing. David Fitzgerald has come back out the field and Melrick has been fouled. He's up close and personal with Shane O'Donnell, this time too much so.
Left arm over the shoulder of Shane O'Donnell there, you can see it. Too anxious. Another opportunity for Tony Kelly to put a bit more distance between the teams.
So Tony Kelly missed the last one. He's missed that one as well. Look, you don't see that often.
No, you just don't. Yeah, just snatching at him a small bit, Patrick Horgan, the same way it was like that in the first half. Just that rhythm of the swing isn't there. It's more of a snatch.
It's also an indication of the tension, the pressure, their last game. Their fate is in their own hands. And it something has happened here now with one of the Cork.
Mayorishka again.
Yeah. So this has been a constant theme of the championship as well in football and hurling.
They don't want him getting messages out onto the pitch. If you do, you get a yellow card.
Well, apologies if you picked up some colourful stuff, let's say. A bit early for that on a Sunday afternoun, and actually,
he's up to
the other side. Oh, okay.
Just can we get on with the game? Just they check him for earpieces before the match, they check him for messages going in. It's look. I don't know. There's no sanction for the yellow card, like, it's just your ball boy, and that's it. Let's get back to playing hurling, let the puck out go, don't let the rhythm of this game die.
Yeah. Where's Dermot Ryan for Clare? He's got the last 2 points for them. Separated by 4 minutes, that's out of play. Just a confirmation, the two Mayor Ishkas getting yellow cards for coming onto the pitch. Dara Fitzgibbon is going to come off the pitch for Cork and be replaced by Tim O'Mahony. Here's Shane O'Donnell, Jerry Mellerick there with him, Peter Duggan. Duggan spins back around. Well, that was a hit and hope job, and it was Shane Kingston who was back there playing like a left halfback, an old left halfback, let's say, who did his stuff.
Great work from Shane Kingston there, coming back. He's drifted out to the half-forward line. Patrick Horgan and Harnady are inside.
Duggan didn't fancy taking it on. Tony Kelly just flicking the ball 3 times, and he's managed to keep it alive somehow. Jerry Mellerick across to him. Good defending by the Cork man. Well, actually, it was illegal defending. It looked like he'd done his job initially, but he wrapped the 2 arms around. Free in Clare, tricky angle.
A little by Adam Hogan with one on the other side. Maybe the grab of the right hand is for Mellerick is the one that was given for, but Tony Kelly could see the corner flag anyway and decided, sure, bit of contact, down we go, and got the free. But again, the skill from Tony Kelly and a tight sideline to flick the ball past the Cork defender, get it the other side is, again, on real composure. It looks like now Peter Duggan is going to be the next free taker for Clare.
Yeah, Tony Kelly certainly won't be. He's running back down the field. So Luke Mead off, Tim O'Mahony on. He made a big impression and impact when he came out against Tipperary and Peter Duggan.
No.
No. So you really don't expect Clare to have. Yeah, yeah. Now Aidan McCarthy goes off. Then Tony Kelly, who was flawless against Waterford. That's just one of those things. One of those days. Rory Hayes went after that. David Fitzgerald, not as big an impact on the game in the second half as he would have liked. As they're trying to pick up the ball, Rob Downey is there, and here comes David Fitzgerald. Class is permanent. Shane Amorey, and Morey on the way. No pressure on him. Morey's got one in the game already. It's just kissed the upright. And Damien Cahalan was the quickest to react. Aaron Shanahan couldn't get to it, and that's down into space. John Conlon filling that space. Harnady was there with him. There was no foul. Pat Ryan wanted one down underneath us. Adam Hogan playing a lot of hurling in a dangerous area. Shane Amorey, he's been very good since coming on, and Morey has the vision and the skill to get it to Dermot Ryan. Remember, he scored the last 2 for Clare. The hat-trick of points will have to wait, though.
Been tracked well by Fitzgibbon.
Patrick Collins forced way over the field. John Conlon was out in front of Seamus Harnady. and Rory Hayes on hand to help. He took a risk with that, but got away with it. Ryan Taylor, Dermot Ryan, has a look and has a go. But this is going to drop in under David Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald, no, it's Aaron Shanahan indeed in a full forward there. Physically similar enough. Mostly white helmet though, that's Niall O'Leary. And O'Leary up to Patrick Horgan. They could do with a goal. They trail by three. Horgan! Oh, and he's got it! Patrick Horgan has got it, and the sides are level again.
Yeah, cut it over McInerney, who's struggling slightly, I would say. He's gone inside in the full back line now. You see him there slow on the turn. Eber Quilligan won't be overly happy. He dived past it. Can't move your feet. He thought Horgan was going to fire it to the bottom right-hand corner as he comes in. Didn't hit it straight down the middle and squirmed under the keeper.
Six times level. What is it? Four, six times get up. Seven. Clare have been hit with another sucker blow. And David McInerney responds in the only way he knows how. They lead by one.
Found the energy from somewhere now to get up. It's great leadership. McInerney. Cork are turned over here again, maybe.
Clare, 10 points from play. They found another gear from somewhere. Shane O'Donnell missed a couple. He's not going to miss from there. And a little clench of the left fist.
Great response from Clare to get the next two after
16
that.
16 from play. Sorry, Brandon.
Yeah, after okay. The goal.
Listen to that. Well, they were right there with them, and they're still there with them. Clare 2-19, Cork 3-14. Rob Downey skidding on the ground. Dara Fitzgibbon. And he's been fouled. I think he probably would have preferred to play on because there was an opportunity for them, but look, they'll take the free.
See again, has been Duggan's left hand in there, dragging him back. Again, he doesn't close the fist. Maybe he's just pulling up on the arm there. By the way, it's fine margins around the middle of the field.
It is, yeah.
A guy of that pace is breaking in.
Who'd be a manager? First year, Pat Ryan, and this is as tense as it gets. And that's Decky Dalton, and that one is right over the black spot. The practice paid off.
As a manager, though, there's the Pat Ryan down there. He must be delighted the way his players have responded. And Tony Kelly potted that penalty. Seems like ages ago now. It looked like that they were beating Docket, but they haven't. They fought back fierce well. Cork is showing unbelievable guts and fight here in Cusick Park.
They're going to bring Brian Hayes in to see if he can do as he did against Tipperary, getting that late goal just seconds after coming on. He'll be on for Cork very shortly. That is David McInerney. The Clare crowd behind him love this, and he's come to life.
He'll be tick over the fact that Horgan caught the ball over his head and spun it into the net. He scored two of the next 3 points then from Clare.
...2-20, 3-15. What a game. And there's another doozy to come later from Thurles. Shane Amory. Oh, he's taken off it by Kingston, but it's come to Peter Duggan, and it's shoot on sight stuff. The confidence is up, but that one has tailed to the left and wide. Declan Dalton off. Brian Hayes from St. Finbar's is his replacement. And Clare have Shane Meehan in from the banner. Really exciting young talent. That's Ian Galvin who's gone off.
Yeah, he's shaking the head there to run and taking off. It's a tight day out for him.
Niall O'Leary. Ger Mellorick. Mellorick hops off Shanahan. Now, direct running from Brian Roach. And Roach was fouled, just dragged back.
Yeah, good decision. Yep. Clare supporters don't like it, but his left shoulder was pulled back. He was just after getting inside. I think it was Cathal Malone out there. Just dragged back.
Everybody out there has put in a an incredible physical effort. You can see just how gassed Cathal Malone is, and even then he still keeps going. Patrick Corgan with the free. It's a biggie. It's a big free, and it's been converted from Patrick Corgan with under 2 minutes to go, just over a minute to go. They've scored 6 points from frees.
The draw is still alive here.
It is. Down to one. Joyce. Here's Brian Hayes. Hayes just lets it off. That hand pass was right on the edge, wasn't it? Shane Barrett. Barrett in a tricky position. Dermot Ryan there with him. Shane Kingston, they've given him space. They let him shoot and they're level. They gave him far too much space. And Shane Kingston, leave him in that position, and from further out he'll score. Teams tied up again. Now, David Fitzgerald trying to give them the lead once more. What about that? It just goes from one end to the other. It's another contender for Game of the Year in the Munster Championship. Stunning.
How is he left all on his own, though, after Kingston got the point earlier? He was blissful isolation out around the middle of the field to get a great puck out from Quilligan.
Now, it's all about the fourth official and how much he decides to add on. Shane O'Mori's been awesome since coming on. Shane O'Donnell was fouling Ger Mellerick.
Brian Morton's going mad down the sideline there.
4 minutes. Just the four. And this is Patrick Corgan. Clear of a 9 different scorers.
This will be some hit if he gets it.
They're two wing-backs, 3 points each. Patrick Corgan from downtown. And, well, it wouldn't have mattered because the referee has penalised Cork for some pulling and dragging and stuff like that. One of the Clare players, there's Adam Hogan with the helmet off. I have no idea how that happened. But anyway, it's delicately poised.
He's retaken the free.
Oh, he's retaken it.
Yeah, he only spotted that Hogan had the helmet off and he stopped play. I thought it was for a flick that Seamus Harney would have had inside and Rory Hayes.
That's certainly the way it looked initially. So Patrick Horgan will get another go. Adam Hogan has just thrown the helmet back behind the end line. Maybe the helmet is broken and of zero use to him.
Funny enough,
anymore.
Clare can't get a hurling ball anywhere. Look, there it is, the interference with the helmet.
Yeah. So that helmet is broken and Adam Hogan has a replacement. So here we go, Patrick Horgan again. Ball on the way. Is it going to draw in?
Yep.
Oh my word, it is.
Some score.
That's stunning.
Started 4 or 5 feet outside that right post. He had a good sighter from the first on there, to be fair. He gave a fella a second go. He learned. That's why he's good as he is.
That's one of those Lowry McIlroy golf shots I was talking about from last night at Oak Hill. Horgan can do it too. What a game. What a championship. It's a brilliant occasion. Here's Rob Downey. Shane O'Mori there after it. Kingston got a flick on that. He's an absolute wizard with that sort of stuff. Hogan comes out, free out. We've had 2 of the 4 additional minutes.
Maybe a booking as well for Brian Hayes inside there. Just high.
So the yellow card for Brian Hayes of Cork.
They have to try to get this ball down on top of Peter Duggan. He's very central. And I thought he might have pulled out to the side a bit to get Downey one-on-one.
Brandon, go ahead.
Yeah, Joyce is just moving back there between the 14 and 21 where he reckons it'll land. He's the spare man for Cork to sweep it up.
A draw for Clare and they're left waiting on what happens next weekend. That's Brian Roach. And Roach has just put that away to John Conlon. Conlon flicks it low, Dermot Ryan. The wing-backs have been helping out massively with the scoring. So this is the last minute. Shane O'Mori. Mori steadies down. Oh, well, he knew there was a huge amount on that. Damien Cahalan. It's like one of the shots I used to take. That's Rob Downey for Cork into the space, defended by Rory Hayes. This has had absolutely everything. Eva Quilligan.
Now,
let's see. One last chance for Dermot Ryan. It's on its way. It's on its way from Dermot Ryan, and he's got it. Unbelievable.
Score. Oh, my goodness.
Well, come at the hour and all that stuff, but he's been awesome. And they lead by a point. Is that the point that takes them to the Munster final? The 4 minutes are just about done. Here's Tony Kelly. Kelly keeps the ball in play. He did keep it in play with the boot that time. Ger Mellerick. And Mellerick is fouled. And, well, that's a kind of good foul, you would say, from a Clare point of view, because it's a long way up there. One of the Clare players down on the ground, clutching his face. I think it's Tony Kelly.
Yeah, we have a fair bit of what we call simulation creeping a bit into the game, but the reason Tony's doing that here is that we are deep, deep into stoppage time to slow the whole thing down. He's taking the opportunity now. The ref, I'm sure, will have stopped the clock. Having a chat. What a score. What a point on the far side to potentially the winner.
So,
Tony may have won a throw-in here for his team.
But there was a yellow card.
Yeah, he's throwing it in.
He is throwing it in.
He is.
And how much more will the referee allow after this? Is there one last chance for Cork? This, these tight games, a great game to win, a horrible game to lose. And Patrick Collins has been called out to take this free. So we're over 5 minutes of added time now. And there's Dermot Ryan. There is the whistle. What an epic encounter again in the Munster Championship. And what a day for Dermot Ryan and for Clare. This place is back to being a fortress again. They're into the Munster final. But spare a thought for Cork. They're going to have a big say.
Cork have been unbelievable today, in fairness to Cork. Brian Lohan below, shaking hands with the Cork backroom team. But how fitting it was that Dermot Ryan would be the man to catch the last ball after that point he got to put Clare into a Munster final. What an unbelievable game. But Pat Ryan can take huge amounts from what Cork have done here today. They've been absolutely fantastic. Looked like they were beating Docking when Tony Kelly stuck the penalty. But by God, they came back roaring. They now have a big game in the Gaelic grounds
in a few weeks' time. Yes, they do. We'll give you the full-time score. What a game. Clare, 2:22. Cork, 3:18.
What a game and what a finish. Thank you, Dara. Thank you, Brendan. So this is what the table looks like. Clare are through to the Munster final. They remain in the All-Ireland Championship. They are finished now in Munster. Remember, they're on a rest weekend next week. Cork now have to get something almost certainly from their trip to Limerick next week. Of course, Tip and Limerick are coming up next at 4 o'clock. OK, with more analysis to this game to come in just a couple of minutes.
Penalty put us up 9 points, I think, and we let Cork back into it. Huge character by the boys, Dermot Ryan, that last catch. And blessed relief now, and a bit of a break. And obviously we saw the injury to Conor Cleary, Eden McCarthy taken off. Missed a few frees after that, but maybe he was carrying the knock from last week. But huge relief from a Clare point of view, back in the Munster final. We haven't won it since 98, and I'd love if we won it again.